Thank you, Mr. Filis. Now invite to the stage Mr. Theodore Ioannou, Group Technical Superintendent of BSMLS, who will talk about how we make maintenance smarter through digital transformation. I should add at this point that BSM is the charity sponsor of today's conference that supports the Elpida Association of Friends of Children with Cancer Organization. Mr. Ioannou, please come to the stage.
Hello, good morning. Okay, I will try today to approach a subject on a tangential point of view to what was discussed, and in particular how we can optimize vessel performance through maintenance. I think we can all agree that you cannot optimize unless everything works properly with your assets. But before that, let me talk a bit about our company. We are a family-owned, 140 years old company with 11 ship management centers, 28 crew service centers, 5 maritime training centers, and 7 representative offices around the globe. The structure of our company can be seen here. We have the ship owning part with Bernhard Schulte, the ship management part where I also work for, Bernhard Schulte Ship Management, and the rest of the maritime services spanning from new building supervision, catering agencies, and of course software development with Mariups. So this is the agenda today, how we made maintenance smarter, what steps we need to take, and also the 4 pillars that we based this upon. So initially, what we did is that we looked how we can upgrade our robust existing procedures in order to include within our maintenance and spare parts strategy new technologies, new ideas, how we could utilize overhaul kits for major plant maintenance events, and how we can proactively coordinate with makers in order to have these on board in time and when needed. Also through the smart maintenance project that orchestrated all this, and in particular a spin-off of this, the smart reporting, how we can digitize all our maintenance records in order everything to be within our ERP system, and we can perform any data analytics we wanted, and of course what KPIs we could generate, holistic KPIs, so that we can describe more appropriately our maintenance. And of course, it goes without saying, we had to look what technologies are out there that are Industry 4.0 related and compatible with the digital transformation strategy that BSM has. So we had to look at different condition monitoring techniques, which ones are digitally friendly, how we could utilize augmented reality for remote troubleshooting, remote surveys, and so on, virtual reality for training, and of course how major makers could assist us on 24/7 remote and digital support to our crew. So the first pillar, condition-based maintenance, of course this is not a new subject. However, the technology in the past years have changed dramatically, so we had to cultivate this new culture into our seafarers and our office staff. We had to bring in the various techniques as mentioned, and of course something that I will mention many times in my presentation is how we could make our ERP system, PAL, and in particular PMS, interface with different vendors and their findings for condition monitoring. How we could have, as a partner in this journey, classification societies in order to acquire machinery plant maintenance condition monitoring notation. This is a notation that allows you to extend overhaul intervals, of course, reduction of OPEX and increase of time between overhauls, and last but certainly not least, how we could increase safety and productivity of our crew and vessels. So what we have right now, here you can see an example of a what we call job order. These are instructions of what maintenance events and plans the crew needs to take. And what we are doing right now is that the crew performs an activity, takes a measurements, everything through cloud and secure internet connection goes to the vendor and back to our office. And then you can see here the reporting part of this activity. The part in the red area is automatically entering our system, and it's not just a text with what is the fault that was identified and the recommendations. The PMS now has the ability to understand what this says and proposes automatically to our crew one-time unplanned jobs to be done based on what is recommended here. So everything is automatically within our system. We did not stop there, of course. Here you can see an example of vibration analysis. We have a centralized page where the office staff and the crew can discuss the various measurement points and diagnostics that came. Each entry here refers to an equipment, and you can see here that we can identify for each equipment what are the faults. We can visualize a trend pattern to see better and understand what was the impact of the diagnosis. And of course, we have an online chat with our crew to discuss the specific areas for the problem identified. So here you can see the history of faults for a particular equipment. Everything here is automated, as I said, through APIs. You can see what is the diagnosis and the fault for this one. Very important for us, the report, the PDF report from the vendor to be automatically attached within the system so that at any time you can see the whole details of what is going on, download it, share it with perhaps the owner and discuss. And of course, as I said, a trend pattern and graphical representation of what is going on. So what we have, all our managed vessels have a subscription for fuel, water, and oil analysis. We have more than 60 vessels now under vibration analysis. More than 5 vessels have MPMSEM notation, and we have more coming within this year. And of course, as I said at the beginning, we wanted to cultivate into our crew and to our office staff the condition monitoring culture. So what we have is that we have created career progression training courses for our seafarers and training sessions for our fleet teams in order to continuously be up to date with what is out there and what is coming. And some numbers, which I think all of us will appreciate. Since the introduction of condition monitoring, we have identified an optimization in machinery condition by 40%. Only from vibration analysis, we've seen savings of $20,000 per vessel from the first year of implementation. And for what we call pre-dry dock evaluation, where you can use vibration analysis to prioritize which equipment you need to overhaul and which you can skip, we have identified savings of $35,000 per vessel for the specific dry dock. Another pillar, as I said, remote support. We wanted to have the necessary infrastructure on board our vessels in order to conduct remote surveys and assist our crew. Have a stable wireless network coverage, both while the vessel is sailing and close to shore. And of course, being able to communicate with our crew with a live streaming video 24/7. Here you can see an example of the office communicating with the crew in a live streaming session. This is a pressure test for a fuel injector that you can see here. The vessel was in the middle of the Atlantic at that point, and you can see the quality of the video that we have there. So we have the necessary infrastructure to provide Wi-Fi anywhere on board our vessels. We are able now to use augmented reality to conduct remote troubleshooting and remote surveys. We have more than 25 vessels with these capabilities, and a lot more are coming this year. And we are in close cooperation with WorldLink and Starlink for better internet connectivity and packages. Of course, some numbers here. Because we had in one vessel the capability for a remote survey, we managed to avoid 3 days of hire. This was a survey with a class, and this resulted in savings of $30,000. And you can understand, by using such technologies, you can reduce traveling costs, taxis, launch boats. So this also reduces your carbon footprint, which is accumulative with every case. Diagnostics. This picture shows everything that we wanted to achieve, basically in-house, with the diagnostics and analytics that we wanted to have. So we wanted to have condition monitoring, and now we are doing it for all our machinery and our main engines. We have in-house full diagnostic systems. Where they provide you not only what is the fault, but also recommendations and what actions the crew needs to take in order to understand better what this means and how we can make the condition of the equipment better. Prognosis. We have a partnership with WinGD where we have we can identify now the remaining useful life of certain components for the main engine, and with other companies like Ocean AI. And finally, as I said also at the beginning, with automated one-time unplanned jobs, our system can assist the crew in the office to take decisions with respect to maintenance. Of course, all these, we wanted to have our ERP independent to outside vendors, so not only being able to communicate with one type of vendor, but with everyone. And also PAL, our ERP again, to be able to integrate seamlessly with multiple vendors. So what we have, I think it was also mentioned before, APIs is a technology that we use to transfer fast and reliably information within our systems with all these different vendors. We have the various in-house algorithms. Here you see an example of what we call image fault recognition algorithm, where we mainly use it in the scavenge, the monthly scavenge space inspections, where the crew takes a picture and then uploads the data. The algorithm recognizes possible faults on the pistons, piston rings, liner, and not only that, it gives you the confidence level of the identified fault and also the specific area within the photo that it thinks a fault is, and all these are automatically within our PMS. As I said, the maintenance KPI, a tool that the top management and also the superintendent level can use. We divide that into the maintenance process KPI, where mainly refers to how well you follow the process, you have overdue jobs or not, how well you perform in that area, and also the quality of the maintenance, how many defects you have, whether the condition of the equipment are good or not. An example of the maintenance process KPI can be seen here. For us, zero is bad, 100% here is good. So you can see we are following up the overdue critical jobs, overdue defects, improper reporting of jobs. As you can understand, the superintendent can focus on areas that require attention. And with that, increase awareness of the crew, and we can have a better quality. Smart reporting, for us, This was clear from the beginning. We wanted to digitize all our maintenance activity reporting forms, something that we call smart forms. Right now, we wanted to introduce validations so that we can improve quality, data quality, generate smart reports at any time and perform analytics, all of that, having it within our ERP system, everything there, no Excel or off-system forms. So what we have right now is the smart forms can be generated, any kind of smart form, depending on the demand, can be generated with a matter of days. No development effort, which used to take 2 to 3 months in the past. Every form is vessel specific and dynamic, which means that the crew spends only time to fill in data that is required and not asking them to put the effort on data entry on irrelevant parameters. We have guidance for our crew, what we want them to measure, how to measure it within the forms itself, not on different places that sometimes might be time-consuming and confuse them. Any evidence also attached within the forms and our ERP. And finally, we can perform any data analytics at any time we require. Again, no Excel forms, Word forms, off-system forms in general. And finally, and I will leave you with that, as I said, in BSM, we approach the matter of performance holistically. So we also have a dedicated department, the Fleet Performance Center. You can see some of the tools and products that we provide there, like voyage optimization, hull and propeller performance, but of course, EU ETS, dashboards and services, and CII services. And with that, I will leave you. Thank you very much.